hey, this is my old Vito Pro bag. Empty of everything but the sawdust. There's still a bunch of sawdust in here, and we're not going to count that. What I really wanted to do was to weigh it, because I was always curious how much it weighed empty. I knew what it weighed full, a lot. Well, actually, I never did weigh it when it was full. I should have weighed it before I took everything out of it. Oh well, I'll be able to do that in a minute. But I really wanted to know what it weighed empty, because I've got something else I want to show you that weighs a little bit more. So it weighs, take my hand off of it, it weighs 9 pounds empty. Now let me show you something else that weighs a little bit more. This is the Doctor from Occidental Leather. It's their new bag. I don't know if any of you have seen one of these, but look at this thing. Let me spin this around. It looks like a big doctor's bag. And you fold down the flaps. You can even fit your hammers in here. There's so much room, you can actually put your hand tools on one side and your really snazzy kind of electrical tools and stuff on the other, and the little wrenches each have a little spot to go in right here, so you can separate them, and the sleeves for them aren't too deep and they aren't too big, so you can actually find the stuff. It doesn't get buried down inside of the sleeve, and you can see every single thing in here at a glance. It's an awesome bag at a slightly awesome price, but we'll get to that. So what's it weigh? Well, let's get it on the scale here. It comes in at 42 pounds full. Now this is the same stuff I had in my Vito bag. There's nothing in here that I didn't put in my Vito bag. So I know that this bag weighs 15 and a half pounds empty, because I weighed it before I filled it up. So with a little math, we can actually figure out exactly how much that Vito bag weighed when it was full. Now don't get me wrong, I like my Vito bag. This lasted me a long time. It doesn't show any signs of wear, and I beat it up really bad. And like I said, it held a lot of little tools. The only problem was, it was sometimes hard to find stuff, because tools were buried behind tools. Sometimes tools got buried down inside the sleeves. And with the Doctor, I don't have that problem. It's easy for me to get to stuff. The bag isn't that much longer, but still there's a lot more room in here to separate all of my bits and all of my wrenches, and I can still get my calculators, my moisture meter, my laser detector, my spring clamps, my laser measure, my low angle block plane. That's a must. My little rabbiting plane for hanging doors and fixing jams. I can get all of that stuff in here. I got all of my protractors in here. I've got the angle finder for my CAPEX in here. And on the other side, I've got the hold down for the CAPEX right here. And then I've got all of my metal cutting stuff. I've got some pry bars, drill index, a bunch of pencils. Gotta have a bunch of pencils. My square, just a whole bunch of stuff. My chisels fit in here in the little chisel holders. A couple of bits for my Craig jig. I've got everything in here. And in this side pocket right here, I've got my little laser device, little line laser, and in these pockets, I've got all of my jigsaw blades, herring protection, everything you need. In this sleeve right here, I've got my little Japanese saw. It slides right into that sleeve. I've got just about everything in here I need, and I've even got room for a little more. But it weighs a bit more than that Vito bag. In fact, I figure it weighs about 7 pounds more full. Which isn't a lot when you think about it, especially if you're somebody like me. I work in my shop here mostly. When I gotta go someplace, I just pack up this bag. It's got handles on the sides, so I can pick it up from the sides set it in my Sprinter, and when I get to the next road show, Tom picks it up and carries it right to where I'm going to be setting my tools up. But seriously, this bag is not cheap. The Doctor from Occidental Leather, $475.
I'm talking about money. Don't you mess with my money. Cause if you mess with my money, then you know you've been messing with me.